All right, we're back. What's the answer, Michael?
So do you want me to work it through?
Sure.
So what I did first is I made I extended the table that you had.
Okay.
To include each of these, the output for each of these three functions. What I'd like to do is compute the squared error for each of these three functions on that data, and then choose the one that has the lowest squared error.
Makes perfect sense to me. Sounds good enough to be an algorithm. So you want me to write out the table?
Well, I mean, so I started to do that, and then it was like one too many steps, and I just threw up my hands and just wrote a program.
Okay, so we'll just say, you know, insert code here. So that's what you did. That was the steps. And what did your code tell you?
Well, let me start with the constant function, because that's the easiest piece of code. So I'm saying, what's the difference between each of the d values and 2, squaring them all and summing it up? And I get 19.
Okay. No, 19.
Exactly. And then I can do the same thing. Instead of using 2, I can use x over 3, take the difference of that to the d values and square that, and I get 19.4.
Wow.
4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. And then I can do, right, so now at this point I'm rock and roll, and I can actually just substitute in mod 9, and I get 12.
Not something mod 12?
No, just 12, yeah. So the error is 12. So that has the smallest error. So even though that's sort of a crazy, like, stripey function, right, like, it increases linearly, and then it resets at 9.
Mm-hmm.
It actually fits this data the best.
That is correct. Your code is correct, Michael. Well done. Well, actually, by looking at this data, that sort of makes sense to me, right? Because if you look at the first three examples of the data, the outputs are very close. But the outputs of the next three are much bigger. And by doing a mod 9, what you effectively do is say, this is the identity function above this line. And then below the line, it's as if I'm sort of subtracting 9 from all of them, and that makes them closer together.
Hmm.
And so it just happens to work out here. But surely that's just because we came up with a bad constant function and a bad linear function. Do you think there's a better linear function?
So, I mean, because it's the squared error, we're really just talking about linear regression. So
yep.
I can just run linear regression. So I get an intercept of 0.9588 and a slope of 0.1647.
Okay,
so that's my linear function of choice.
Okay, so that's what was that again?
So x times, you know, it's like a 6, I guess, like 0.165, call it.
0.165x
plus 0.959. So that's our function. That's our best linear function, the function that minimizes the squared error. So it better end up being it better end up being less than 19.4, or I'm a liar.
Mm-hmm.
And now I need to take the difference between that and D, square it, and sum. 15.7.
So that gives you 15, I'm going to say 15.8. So that is better.
Yeah, so it's better than the x over 3, but it's also worse than the mod 9.
Hmm.
And the best constant function has to be worse because the linear functions include the constant functions as a subset. So this is that 15.8 is better than the best constant function, too. Oh, it's easy to do, though, right? Because the best constant function is just the mean of the data.
What is the mean of the data?
2.17.
Huh, 2 is pretty close.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Well, that's,
I guess, kind of the middle of the pack, I guess.
That sort of works, right? Because the error for 2 was actually lower than the error for x divided by 3.
And for what it's worth, the error for 2.17 as a constant function, or 2.2, is 18.8, sorry.
Yeah, you're about to worry me there.
Yeah, 8 would have been less than everything.
Okay, so what have we learned here?
That sometimes you want to use mod.
Yeah.
If your data is weird.
You have you have definitely modified my thoughts.
Ah, I'm glad you found it mod.
Mm. Puns. Okay, good. So I think that was a good exercise. So I'm going to give you one more example of deriving something, and then we're going to move on.
Cool.
Okay.